This is the third part of the lecture two, starting a clinical engineering department. It will be about the business plan. We should cover 4 points. The first point will be the plan itself. Then we will talk about the reporting channels, the traditional one and the recent one. Then finally, we'll talk about the educational programs for managers and biomedical technicians inside the clinical engineering department service. So as a business, now we will start to talk about how to develop a business plan. Once all the numbers are in and the plan is solidified, it's now best to present the results in a business plan format to the administration. This would include a mission and a vision statement of the new department and how it fits into the hospital. Secondly, we should talk about the services which will be provided by the department. This will include the engineering services, maintenance, and so on, and other type of services like, as we said before, the consultation services, assessment services, the incident investigation services, training services, special projects, and so on. Then a startup and ongoing cost over at least a 3 year period should be included. Finally, a timelines for this plan should be made. The plan now must be presented credibly and clearly with a concise explanation of where the cost figures came from, a comparison with the alternatives, and finally a discussion of the value added benefits of the healthcare technology management which cannot be provided quantitatively. So if the approval is given, if the okay is given, we should ensure that we follow through on all what was promised. So a commitment for the plan should be done. In case if the problems arise, it's very important to justify the changes and communicate. The TE department administration and management job responsibilities include, firstly, recruiting and retention, setting the salaries and benefits, assessing competency and match to work through a competency test, a yearly or annual competency test, or based on the requirements, evaluating the performance through the use of performance indicators, giving directions and motivation, settling disputes, and taking disciplinary action. CE departments need to track all work and cost. Administrators may need to cost due to the limitation on the budgets or some challenges. In this case, either they will ask the department to drop employees, in which case the CE director has to justify the services and position with data, or unfortunately or alternatively, the administration may seek a competitive bids from outside vendors. So CE directors have to show their value with data. If they cannot measure it, they cannot manage it. Department must stand ready with a real-time data and reporting to show their value and to face such cases such as the cut out, the cut costs, as we said before, and also include customer surveys and feedback in your justification. It should be done to justify your report. Now we will talk about reporting. We have a traditional structure for reporting and we have a new type, a newer type. Traditionally, the traditional structure was for clinical engineering reporting, clinical engineering to be under facilities. Thus, the CE reporting was done to the VP of the support services or the materials management. Also, CE has also reported to the nursing. Recently, a newer development is the reporting of CE to the information services. Now we will talk about the educational program, which will be the last point. We will talk about the educational program for managers and the educational programs for the biomedical technicians. Most managers are usually, previously, they were clinical engineers. They have a strong technical background and technical skills. However, they lack some managerial skills. So a managerial at a managerial level, a training is important in the following areas for them to fit the new post. This includes training in the communication, interpersonal skills, situational leadership, problem solving, setting employee standards and measuring results, finally, a teamwork. In general, it's a difficult transition from a technical work to a supervision work where managerial skills are needed. For this, we need a training to fill this gap. As for the biomedical technicians, the education should build employees to move to the next level and address weak areas or focus on changes in the field. Such a training usually is done, can be taken in different forms, for one of them a classroom or in the job, online or books and or other alternatives. Sometimes on specialty areas, a background training is should be provided. For example, in radiology. Also, like other machines like laser, ultrasound, ventilators, sterilizer, IT, and many other specialty areas are now covered by a third-party education for the biomedical technicians. Specific device service training is best negotiated at the purchase phase. So during purchasing, we should negotiating this part. As for the training, the service training should be done during the warranty period and preferable to be near or close to the end of the warranty period. Usually when we send a staff to a training, it should have a strong background to get the most benefit prior to go to the training. After coming from the training or upon return from training, there should this member should share his knowledge with other team members through what known as a cross training. Cross training in general is a good practice, and we encourage to use it to increase the knowledge and the skills of all the staff inside the department. Generally, the benefits of service training for the biomedical technicians or even clinical engineers is to expand expertise, reduce long-term cost, build morale, and decrease the equipment downtime.